name of Jesus, show me mercy. Let the demonstrate the grace of God upon my life. Look, you have deposited so much. You have given me so much. You have anointed me so much. You have blessed me so much. You have endowed me so much. You have given me gifts and talents. Help me not to demonstrate your grace upon my life. Open your mouth and ask the Lord. Help me not to demonstrate your grace upon my life. In the name of Jesus. Don't stay quiet on me. Ask the Lord to help you. To help you to truly live for Christ. To help you to truly live for Christ. Ask the Lord to help you to truly live for Him. In the name of Jesus. God help me not to frustrate the grace of God upon my life. Keep me in the straight and narrow. Help me to walk circumspectly with you. In the name of Jesus. Help me, dear Father. Help me, dear God. Oh, back in the bush, for your man, don't give up on me right now. Don't stay quiet on me. Ask the Lord to help you from the depth of your soul. Ask the Lord to help you not to live your life the way you please, but to live your life the way that pleases Him. Not to live your life, oh God, the way you want, but that which He requires of you. Ask the Lord to help you tonight, that you do not make a mess of yourself, that you do not let the world laugh after Him. Ask the Lord to help you not to frustrate the grace of God upon your life. Oh God, help me. Oh God, help me. Help me to live for you. Help me to walk with you. Help me to run the race that has set before me. Help me, dear Father, in the name of Jesus. He controls the in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Open your eyes and look at me. If you truly want to grow, it is important that you pray. Because prayer helps you grow. Prayer transforms you. That ordinarily you cannot do by yourself, prayer empowers you. That is why I encourage you, I push you, I challenge you to pray. That you do not be like any other person going to church Sunday after Sunday. Every time church opens, you are there. But nothing about your life changes. Devil is a liar. Because you have to understand that He that has called you wants to do something awesome in your life. But until you give Him, until you hand over the key of your life to Him, nothing happens for you. That is why when we pray, we say, let your kingdom come. Let that which you have predestined for my life before the foundation of this world, let it manifest while I am on earth. Prayer is what gives God the authority to work on your behalf. Because if you do not pray, nothing happens for you. You have to push yourself. You don't have to like it. It's a discipline. I don't like to pray, but I have to discipline myself because I know it is expedient for me. If I want to go far in life, I have to bring this body to submission and say, pray. You have to. Because if we don't, the enemy will mess us up. Trust me. Because when you pray, prayer becomes an edge around you that the enemy cannot penetrate you.
God. Yes, Lord.
See, a prayerless Christian is a powerless Christian. Amen. No matter how born again you claim to be, if you don't pray, If you are not prayerful, the enemy will knock you about.
Sure.
You don't understand. Even the people that do not know Christ, they pray. They spend until they are devoted to that which they believe in, even though it is wrong. But we that believe in the power of the highest, we are plain lazy. We believe God. God is not obligated to you. You are obligated to God.
Yes.
God is not in heaven because of you. You are here because of Him.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
God doesn't need you. You need Him.
Jesus.
You need Him.
Yes, Lord.
So prayer brings Him to your domain.
Amen, Lord.
That is why we encourage you to pray. Open your mouth and pray. It's not about me. It's about you. That destiny, that purpose, that calling God has inside of you. If you don't pray, it will not manifest. It will not. That is why I encourage you to pray. Hallelujah. Turn your Bibles with me to Isaiah 29. Isaiah 29. Hallelujah. Isaiah 29, look at verse 13. Oh, Jesus. Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13. Isaiah 29, 13. He said, wherefore the Lord say. Now, this is God talking. This is church people now. He said, for as much as these people draw nigh to me with their mouths, and with their lips do they honor me, but I've removed their heart far from me, and their fear towards me is taught by the precept of men. This is God talking, you know. How many of you love Jesus? I love you, Lord. With your mouth, you honor Him. With your lips, you sing praises to Him. But your heart is far from Him. You do things for people to see you. Oh, she can praise. Oh, she can worship. But the truth is, your heart is far from God.
Yes.
That is why when somebody backslides, they don't just backslide by going out of church. The backsliding state has already happened in their hearts long before they leave church. Let me tell you how somebody backslide. Somebody got born again. They are excited about the Lord. Everything they want to do is to please the Lord. Because why? Their heart is genuine. As time goes by, all of a sudden, anything anybody does offends them. Anything anybody does offends them. You used to love to pray. All of a sudden, you're tired. Praise and worship. Let them hurry up. I'm tired, Joe. Don't they know so much? I've been standing since. I want to sit down. That's the state of your heart. Now, when you come to church and the usher says, sit there. No, I want to sit somewhere else. How can she tell me to sit there? I'm a big woman. Don't tell me what to do. That is how you know. The things of God no longer concerns you anymore. So when you worship, you just do it because you want to. Not because you're giving God honor. This is God talking now. He said, they come to me. With their mouths, they honor me. With their lips, they give praises to me, but their heart is removed from me. And they only fear me because of what man tells them. Let me give you an instance. You will go to hell. You're afraid because you don't want to go to hell. So you fear the fact that you don't want to go to hell, not because you love God. See, the truth is, we are not conscious about hell. We have to be conscious about the love of God. The Bible says the love of God constrains us. When we love somebody, we want to do the things that pleases them, right? So when we focus on the things that pleases them, hell is not an issue to us. Because we know when we please Him, we definitely know that where He is, we will be. But when your heart is removed from Him, see, that is why Luke says, not everybody that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God. And she said, only the one that doeth the will of my Father, they are the ones that will enter. Now, if you look at the scenario of the people God was talking about, not everybody. The Bible says some came and said, Lord, we prophesy in your name. In your name. It means God doesn't even know them. They use the name of God to endorse themselves. You didn't get me. In the name of Jesus, come out! They are living wrong lives. They don't know God. But because they call the name of Jesus, they use the name of God. See, in your name, we. In your name, we. In your name. They didn't say you use us to cast out. In your name, we. So we are casting out your name. We took your name and endorse it so that people will know that it is of God. That is why not every song that they say is gospel is gospel. Let me tell you one song I detest. When Jesus say yes, nobody can say. Who sang the song? Beyonce and who? And everybody sings it, even in church. It sounds good. There is nothing wrong with the song. It's the spirit behind the song. People don't understand. Oh, it's gospel song. It doesn't matter who sings it. Once they glorify Jesus. By what spirit? By what spirit? Now, let me give you a scenario. When Paul was going, every day Paul and I think Peter were going, and there was this particular damsel that had the spirit of divination. And every time Paul passed, she would say, these are the men of God. Yeah, him. They bring the word of salvation. Is she telling the truth? Is she telling the truth? Yes. These men preach Jesus. You have to listen to them. They preach Jesus. You have to listen to them. Every time Paul passed them, was she telling the truth? Yes. But by what spirit? By what spirit? That's what most people don't understand. That's why people get carried away by all manner of doctrines. It sounds good. And they put Jesus' name on it. So it is gospel. And Paul looked at her and said, you spirit of divination, come out. And the Bible says the young lady dropped and the spirit came out of her. Was she preaching the gospel? But of course. Was she telling the people the truth? Does it sound good? But of course. But by what spirits? That is why we have to be spiritually inclined, sensitive. So not everybody that lift up their hand, oh Lord, I love you. Oh Lord, I praise you. I worship you. Sing, yeah. But your heart is far from God. Now, this is a soul search. Your heart. Because the truth is, God is more interested in your heart than your outward appearance.
God, watch the heart.
The Bible says a contrite heart and a broken spirit, right? That's what the Lord requires. Now, that same scripture in Isaiah, go to Matthew chapter 15. Go to Matthew. Look at verse 8. Matthew chapter 15, verse 8. He said, these people draw it unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. They honor me with their mouth. They magnify me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Do you know it's possible that at that point, he said, their heart is far from me? It means they're in a backsliding state. Backsliding state, that everything upset them. Oh, they say to the church, I need to go home. But if you're going to a party, you don't care what hours of time you stay out late.
Amen.
You don't care how long you stay. But when it comes to the things of God, you get irritated. You can't stand God's word for so long. You start looking at your time. Man, I need to go home, you know. That is a backsliding heart. We're going to ask the Lord, search our hearts. Oh, God. Search my heart. If there be any backsliding ways in me, search me. Because it is so easy to lift up our hand because nobody actually sees our heart, you know. That is why Jesus says, don't judge according to appearance. Judge righteous judgments. That is why God looks at our hearts.
It's true.
Mm-hmm. A lot of us are here. Mm-hmm. It's between you and God.
Oh.
Ask the Lord to search your hearts.
Amen.
See, the fact that you are hasty to go out of God's presence is a wicked heart. Mm-hmm. People don't understand when they say God tells you that you have a wicked heart. People don't understand what it means. Mm-hmm. That is a backstory. It's a wicked heart. I'm just tired, I want to go home. Or the things of God doesn't interest you anymore. Do you know, prayerlessness is a sin. How many of you know that? Prayerlessness is a sin. It takes a genuine heart of love to pray to the Father. Because we understand that we are not our own. Lift up your hands and say, Heavenly Father, search my heart.
Search my heart.
If there be any wicked ways in me, every backsliding state in me, help me and purge me. Open your mouth and ask the Lord to help you. He kotorobo kusukuturbiyo kondorobo kushakandarawa sakandarabosa. Rabo kondiribiyo kondorobo kusukuturobo kushakatarabasa. Open your mouth and ask the Lord to help you. That you have a heart after him. You don't only glorify him with your mouth or glorify him with your lip, but your heart is far from him. Ask the Lord to help your heart. Ask the Lord to arise, so God, your priority, your set things for him. Ask the Lord to redesign your motive. Ask the Lord to correct your motive. He can Roto poco de la bocondria, candrava baca, secate de los sondrebos. Roco poco de la baca, sacandrebo. Don't give up on me now. Ask the Lord to help you. Ask the Lord to help you. Purge your heart. This heart of you. The Bible said the heart of man is desperately wicked. Who can know it? Even your own heart can deceive you. If the Lord doesn't help you, ask the Lord to help my heart to be straight with you. God, search my motive. Search me, oh God. If there be any wicked ways in me, open your mouth and ask the Lord to help you. Search me, God. I might be saying I love you, but my heart is far from you. I can be saying, Lord, I worship you. I bless your holy name. But my priority, my desire, my longing, my zeal, my passion are far from you. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. He got a boku sukubusuku talabande. Rokondere boku shokondere boku sikitirimianda. It's between you and your God. He sees your heart. He created you anyway. He said, I shaped you, I formed you. From your mother's womb, I knew you. So I know what you are made of. Why don't you come clean to him anyway? Ask the Lord to help you. If your motives are wrong, if your desires are wrong, ask the Lord to help you. Except the Lord takes away the heart of stone. I give you a heart of that you cannot change. We sing a heart like yours. It's my desire. Full of compassion, nothing wrong within. Ask the Lord to give you a heart for him. A heart for him. A heart for the things that please him. He said, those that please me and do my will, they are the ones that keep my commandment. Ask the Lord. They are the ones that love me. They are the ones that are truly my children. Ask the Lord to purge you. Oh God, here I am, oh God. Search me. Search me. Set my priorities aright. Help me, God. Help me, God. Help me, God. I don't want to lose out on you. I don't want to lose my reason of my uncultivated heart. Of my heart that is wrong. Of my heart that is not passionate for you. Help me, God. That when I say I love you, from the depth of my heart, I mean it, God. When I say I need you, from the depth of my heart, I mean it, God. My heart cannot be saying something else while my lips say something else. I'm only deceiving myself. Ask the Lord to help you. That when you say, Lord, I want to walk for you, you mean it. From the depth of your heart. When you say, Lord, I need you, you mean it from the depth of your heart. Don't give up on me right now. Ask the Lord to purge you. Ask the Lord to cleanse you. He said, with your mouth, they magnify me. With your lips, they magnify me. But your heart is far from me. It's removed from me. the Lord, open your mouth, don't give up on me now. Lord God, here I am, O God, that you will search my heart, that you will search me, O God, that you will purify my heart, O God, that you will take away from me every heart that is not like you, O God. Lord God, mold me, Lord God, shape me, O God, strip everything from me that is not like you, everything in me that doesn't bring you glory, everything in you that doesn't represent you, everything in me, O God, that doesn't bring you honor. Oh God, strip it away from me, oh God, set my heart around. Oh God, help me, oh God, to rearrange my priority. Now when I say I love you, Lord, I mean it. When I say I need you, Lord, I mean it. When I say I desire you, God, I mean it. Because my heart and my desire is towards you. My passion is for you, God. Open your mouth and ask the Lord to search your heart. God, I don't want to backslide. I don't want to lose my love for you. I don't want to lose my passion for you. I don't want to lose my desire, my hunger, my zeal for you. I don't want to lose my thirst for you, God. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Set me on fire for you. A fire that I cannot contain. I cannot control. For I want more of you, Lord. For only you can satisfy my soul. Ask the Lord to help you. Back in Tiribiosa. Don't be like them that glorify the Lord with their mouth, but your heart is nowhere close to God. Ask the Lord to help you. Reckon the assault of us who continue to be us. He can amend the rebel kundur be a kundur bosa. Rock on the rebel kotkoto libia kandrabasa kasakatarabasa. Don't give up on me. Ask the Lord to part you. Oh God, that He may give you the right spirit. He may give you a discerning heart, a sensitive heart, a heart for Him. A desire for Him, a longing for Him, a want for Him. Ask the Lord to help you tonight. Poco sikiti biosa. He can amandru bio kondrebosa. Ask the Lord, help me, Jesus. Poco satanebe kundru biosa. Don't stay quiet on me now. Ask the Lord to purge your heart. A heart that truly loves Him. A heart that truly wants to please Him. A heart that truly desires Him. A heart that truly craves for Him. A heart that truly wants Him. A heart that truly desires Him. He said, these people draw near with me with their mouth. And with their lips do they honor me. But I've removed their heart far from me. God, bring my heart back to my first love. Bring my desires back to my first love. The reason I got saved. Ask the Lord to restore you back to your first love. In the name of Jesus. Restore me back to my first love. Change my heart, oh God. Give me a heart for you. Give me a heart for you. Give me a heart for you. Ask the Lord to help you. Poco sta candribiosa. He can amandere bebe kundurbio kondrebosa que tenemos. Oh God, we love you. Oh God, we love you. Just lift up your hands and magnify the Lord. God, I love you. God, I look to you. Let me want what you want, oh my dear Lord. Jesus. Let my desire be only towards you. Let your will become my will. Let your choice become my choice. Let my life bring glory to your name. Let my life bring glory to your name. That when others see me, they will see you, Jesus. When others look at me, they will see the representation of Jesus in me. Oh God, help me. So chase after the things of you. For only you can satisfy our longing. Give me one pure and holy desire. One magnificent obsession. One glorious ambition for our life. To know and follow after you. For this world is empty, pale and poor. Jesus. But to know you is what we desire. That when men see us, they will give glory to our Father which is in heaven. that our life will become an open book, that through us others may come to Christ, that through us others may see Jesus high and lifted up, oh God. We don't want to frustrate the grace of God upon our life. We don't want to live life on our own, forgetting the one that has died for us, forgetting the one that caused us to be Christians in the first place. Help us there, Father. Keep us a heart like yours, full of compassion, nothing wrong within. Dear Father, keep us a zeal for you according to knowledge, that the eyes of our understanding be enlightened, that we may know the hope of our calling in the name of Jesus, that we may know you, Father, the power of your resurrection and the fellowship of your suffering in the name of Jesus. God, we don't want to be ignorant. We don't want the enemy to use us as his footstool. Oh God, help us, oh God, that we do not perish for lack of knowledge. Lift up your hands. Ah, Father, we give you praise. We honor you. We bless your name. Just love on the Lord tonight. Father, we thank you for prayer answers. We thank you that you are making us better people, better individual, better Christian, better disciple, better followers, God, that we may see you high and lifted up in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I prophesy right now in the name of Jesus that men will testify of the goodness of the Lord upon your life. I decree and declare that when men see you, they will see the reflection of your Father in heaven. Because the Bible says that as he is, so are we in this world. That by reason of your Christian life, others will come to know Jesus. I decree, oh God, and I declare, by reason of your salvation and your walk with God, others will know Jesus. And I prophesy upon you that the enemy will not take you out premature. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy, oh God, that every desires of your heart, the Lord meets them. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy that the Lord will crown your health. The Lord will crown you with success. I prophesy, oh God, that you will be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. You will bring forth your fruits in season. I prophesy that your horn will be exalted like the horn of the unicorn. You will flourish like a palm tree. You will grow like cedars from Lebanon. In the name of Jesus, I decree, oh God, that like when destruction comes, you shall laugh. I decree, oh God, that you shall not be like them that go down. The Lord will raise you up. I decree that the Lord will perfect that which concerned you. You shall be the head and not the tail. You shall run through a troop. You shall leap over walls. In the name of Jesus, I decree that the Lord will empower you to serve him. In the name of Jesus, I decree that you are blessed. And I prophesy to you that when men are saying that there is a casting, and you will say that there is a lifting up. For he that watched over Israel neither slumber nor sleep, but because the word lodged over you, no weapon that has formed against you shall be able to prosper. And every tongue that will rise up against you in judgment, it is condemned even now. In the name of Jesus, though you will gather, but not by him. I decree that anyone that will gather together against you will fall for your sake. In the name of Jesus, I decree, oh God, that the cost-costless shall not happen to you. In the name of Jesus, I decree that the Lord will bless you indeed. Oh God, the Lord will bless you indeed. The Lord will bless you indeed. The Lord will bless the works of your hand. The Lord will empower you. Spirit of the living God, that you will breathe upon the swan, oh God. That you will give them ease, oh God. They will not struggle, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, I decree this day that nothing broken, nothing missing, in the name of Jesus. Look, by reason of this covering, I declare, oh God, that no accident, no incident, in the name of Jesus, they will not lose their loved ones. By reason of this covering, in the name of Jesus, I thank you because their health is restored. That everything that pertains to them, you will restore. In the name of Jesus, you will cause their head to flourish speedily. in the name of Jesus. I decree, oh God, that everything, the caterpillar, the locust, the palmer worm, the canker worm has eaten, you will restore unto them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And above all, you will bring peace. Concerning every situation of their life, you will bring peace. Your peace that passes all understanding shall reign in their heart and soul. For your word declares that you have not given them the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. I decree that they will operate under a sound mind. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just bless the Lord with me. Hallelujah. Okay, give you praise. Right now we're going to do our offering. Oh God, we give you praise.